Once upon a time, the mere mention of China brought to mind a thick, gray haze blanketing the sky, cities where people couldn't leave home without a mask, and giant factories spewing black smoke from their chimneys. Air pollution in Beijing sometimes soared up to 40 times the World Health Organization's safety limits. On some days, seeing the sky was simply impossible. At that time, China was the world's factory, but this title came at a heavy cost. Even breathing was a health hazard. Today, however, the landscape has completely changed. China is no longer just the world's largest manufacturer, but also the driving force of the clean energy revolution. Globally, it produces over 80% of solar panels, 60% of wind turbines, 70% of electric vehicles, and 75% of batteries. In 2024, China became the undisputed leader of the global energy transition, accounting for 39% of all clean energy investments worldwide and driving two-thirds of the total global growth. For the first time, clean energy investment and sales contributed over 10% of China's GDP, reaching a total value of $1.9 trillion. Electric vehicles, batteries, and solar energy alone generated about $1.1 trillion in added value. Renewables are spreading rapidly across China's power grid. By 2024, total renewable capacity, including hydropower, had reached 1,840 gigawatts, making up 55% of total electricity generation capacity, meaning China surpassed its 2030 target of 1,200 gigawatts 6 years ahead of schedule. But how did this happen? How did a country once synonymous with pollution and coal become the manufacturing hub for the world's clean technologies? From solar panels and wind turbines to EV batteries and hydrogen electrolyzers. Moreover, having hit its ambitious target so early, what is China aiming for now? Rapid industrialization, urbanization, and reliance on coal in the early 2000s gave China some of the world's most polluted air, visible health impacts, intense smog events, especially in winter, economic costs, and international image pressure ultimately pushed the central government to search for a measurable, ambitious, and implementable solution. China's transformation strategy unfolded in a two-phase approach. First, during the 12th five-year plan, the infrastructure for environmental monitoring was established. By the end of 2014, over 1,400 air quality monitoring stations were set up nationwide, providing real-time, public data on 6 major pollutants. This data network gave Beijing the power to track pollution sources and hold local officials accountable. Unlike the voluntary or market-based systems in the West, China's top-down enforcement created unprecedented speed and coordination. In 2013, the government launched the Air Pollution Prevention and Control Action Plan, setting strict targets, reducing coal use, promoting clean technology in heavy industries, limiting dirty fuels, and increasing transparency in air monitoring. It was followed by concrete actions, regional coal restrictions, shutdowns of small outdated factories, and mandatory production cuts during pollution spikes. Within just 5 years, major cities saw PM2.5 levels fall by 40%, sulfur dioxide by 65%, and carbon monoxide by 33%. For comparison, achieving similar emission reductions took the US over a decade. Then came the Blue Sky Protection Campaign, adding tighter emission controls and linking local officials' performance evaluations to air quality results. Environmental targets became a matter of political responsibility, not just policy paperwork. But China didn't stop at cleaning the air. It realized that solving pollution could also mean leading a new industrial revolution. As coal restrictions tightened, Beijing began pouring massive investments into renewable energy, electric transport, and battery storage. The same state-driven model that once fueled heavy industry was redirected toward green innovation. China's rise in the solar industry is the most striking example of its industrial power. Today, the country produces over 80% of the world's solar energy equipment, a scale that gives Chinese companies a strong global advantage. Major brands like LONGi Green Energy, Trina Solar, JA Solar, and Jinko Solar lead the market with vertically integrated production lines and advanced high-efficiency panels. China's vast manufacturing capacity has pushed solar panel prices to record lows, making renewable energy more affordable for countries everywhere. This price drop has accelerated the global shift to clean power, especially in developing nations. In doing so, China turned what began as a domestic environmental challenge into a global advantage. Combining technology, scale, and policy to lead the world's green energy transition. The same story played out in wind energy. Chinese giants like Goldwind, Envision, and Mingyang now lead global installations. In 2023, China held 65% of total global wind capacity, with four of the world's top five turbine makers based there. This scale advantage helped China leap ahead of Europe and the US, forcing even European firms to open factories inside China to stay competitive. These figures show that China controls a global bottleneck, not only in the final production stage of clean energy transition, but also in raw material refining. For example, while Australia extracts 55% of global lithium, China refines 60% to 70% of it, making it usable in EV batteries. This means that even Western countries with raw material sources are dependent on China for the finished product. Efforts by the US and the EU to promote domestic production are seriously constrained by China's refining monopoly. Even if facilities are built in the West, critical intermediate materials must still come from China. This control grants China significant leverage, not just economically, but also in terms of national security. China is leading the EV revolution in transportation as well as in renewable electricity generation. Strong government incentives and infrastructure investments rapidly accelerated the shift to electric vehicles. As a result, China is now the world's largest electric vehicle market. According to 2023 data from the International Energy Agency, BYD and Tesla hold the largest share of the global pure electric market, with their combined global market share around 35%. Electric vehicle sales in China grew by nearly 40% in 2024. This surge pushed China's share of global EV sales from about half in 2021 to roughly two-thirds just 3 years later. In recent years, China's clean energy focus has extended beyond electricity generation, with an increasing emphasis on green hydrogen. In November 2024, a new energy law reportedly removed hydrogen from its hazardous chemical status and included it among clean energy sources. Let's briefly open a parenthesis for green hydrogen. Simply put, green hydrogen is obtained by splitting water with electricity. However, what sets it apart is that this process is done using renewable energy sources. This means the electricity comes from wind turbines, solar panels, or hydroelectric power plants. As a result, the carbon emission during the production process is zero. The potential of green hydrogen stems not only from its environmental friendliness, but also from its versatile applicability. Electric cars can run on small batteries, but what about heavy industry or a 10,000-kilometer shipping route? This is where batteries fall short. Green hydrogen, on the other hand, can be used directly in many areas, from steel production and fertilizer manufacturing to trains and ships. Some countries are even planning to reduce their reliance on fossil fuels for heating by blending certain amounts of hydrogen into their natural gas networks. Another important aspect is its energy storage capacity. Solar and wind energy are inherently intermittent. The sun doesn't always shine, and the wind doesn't always blow. Therefore, storing the surplus electricity generated is one of the biggest challenges of renewable energy. Green hydrogen steps in here. The excess energy produced on sunny or windy days is converted into hydrogen by splitting water. This hydrogen can be stored, transported, and used to generate electricity again when needed. This is why many experts define green hydrogen as the missing link of the energy transition. By removing its hazardous chemical classification, China has eliminated a major hurdle in hydrogen production and transmission. By the end of 2023, 387 renewable hydrogen projects were in the planning stage, with 80 under construction and 58 operational, reaching a total annual capacity of 56,000 tons. It is reported that China aims to produce around 6.43 million tons of green hydrogen per year. While much of the current hydrogen is from cheaper coal-based gray methods, massive investments are being channeled into making the process green. Furthermore, a special action plan released in 2024 aims to reduce carbon emissions by 53 million tons and cut coal consumption by 20 million tons by 2025. However, there is currently no widely available, reliable data confirming whether these targets have been achieved. Overall, China's strategy is to normalize the entire spectrum of clean energy technologies in both domestic and foreign markets, determined to establish a clean energy base. Chinese firms are developing solar, wind, and hydrogen projects abroad, exporting low-carbon infrastructure. By 2024, China was responsible for 64% of all new renewable capacity added worldwide, over 260 gigawatts in a single year, more than the rest of the world combined. Although the details of the 15th plan have not yet been clarified, independent projections suggest that China will multiply its renewable energy capacity between 2024 and 2030. Organizations like the IEA estimate China could install over 3.2 terawatts of new renewable capacity in this period. Today, China has surpassed the EU and the US in renewable installations, both in capacity and technology. It is no longer just the world's largest manufacturing center. It has become the epicenter of the global energy transition. The country, once known for smoke-filled cities and coal-fired plants, now single-handedly produces the vast majority of the world's solar panels, wind turbines, electric vehicles, and batteries. This transformation is not just an ecological leap. It's a new economic paradigm and a redefinition of technological superiority. Energy is no longer just a resource to be consumed, but a strategic tool of power. However, that's not the whole story. China is still the world's largest carbon emitter, responsible for about one-third of global emissions. The sheer size of its economy and the intensity of its industry complicate this transition. The energy used to manufacture those solar panels, batteries, and wind turbines still largely comes from coal. Thus, China is simultaneously building the green technologies of the future while bearing the carbon load of the present. This contradiction shows that the country's growth model is still undergoing transformation. China's difference lies in seeing this contradiction not as a dead end, but as a driving force. The government viewed the environmental crisis not just as an ecological threat, but as leverage for economic competitiveness. Decades of planned investment, systems that increased local government accountability, and massive R&D support built the foundation for this transformation. Today, giants like LONGi, CATL, BYD, and Goldwind are shaping the energy future of not just China, but the entire world. Crucially, they are doing this through a state-directed strategic planning approach, unlike the West's market-centric model. While China still grapples with energy hunger, massive industries, and its carbon burden, the course has changed. The gray sky is giving way to blue, and hydrogen facilities are rising alongside coal plants. By single-handedly driving over a quarter of global clean energy investment, China is not just redefining its own future, but also reorienting the world's energy direction, and maybe launching the green industrial age. Thank you for watching us. See you in the next video.